Hello everyone. This video is the second part of utility as a part of theory of consumer behavior. In the first video, we had discussed about marginal utility and total utility. We had seen how utility could be measured in numbers. This is what is called cardinal utility. So, under the cardinal utility analysis or the theory of cardinal utility, it is assumed that the utility is measurable in numbers. In case you need to understand the cardinal utility analysis in detail, you can refer to our previous video. The link is given here. It is also given in the description. Now, let's move on to ordinal utility analysis. We have seen that under the cardinal utility analysis, it is assumed that the utility is measurable in numbers. However, in real life, we never express utility in the form of numbers. The ordinal utility approach or theory believes that utility cannot be measured in numbers, rather it can be ranked according to preference. The consumer must be able to rank the bundle of goods according to the satisfaction he derives from each bundle of goods. For example, a child may say that 5 chocolates give more satisfaction or utility than 5 spoons of vegetables. Also, a consumer consumes a large number of goods. In that case, the consumer may substitute one commodity for another and still be on the same level of satisfaction. As the consumer increases the consumption of one type of commodity, he must reduce the consumption of another type of commodity and vice versa to maintain the same level of satisfaction. For example, a person may get the same level of satisfaction with tea as well as coffee. If he does not get tea, he will have coffee and feels equally satisfied. When we plot this concept graphically, we derived what is called an indifference curve. Let us illustrate the indifference curve using a consumer consuming 2 goods, mango and banana, and having 4 combinations yielding the same level of satisfaction. In this table, in combination A, the consumer consumes 1 unit of banana and 15 units of mango, and he derives a particular level of satisfaction. In combination B, when he increases the consumption of banana to 2 units, the consumption of units of mango decreases to 12 to have the same level of satisfaction as combination A. The above is also called marginal rate of substitution. In other words, the rate at which number of units of mango that can be substituted for commodity banana, leaving the consumer at same level of satisfaction. In our case, if we compare the combination A and B, we can see that the 1 unit of banana has substituted 3 units of mango, so that the satisfaction remains same between combination A and B. We also notice that as the consumption of banana increases, the marginal utility derived from each unit of banana decreases. We have already explained this in our earlier video. Therefore, with increase in consumption of banana and decrease in its marginal utility, the additional units of mango sacrificed are also reduced. In other words, with increase in the number of banana, the consumer will feel the inclination to sacrifice small and smaller amounts of mango. This tendency for the marginal rate of substitution to fall with increase in quantity of banana is known as law of diminishing marginal rate of substitution. Due to the diminishing marginal rate of substitution, the shape of indifference curve is convex to the origin. Let's move on to the properties of an indifference curve. An indifference curve slopes downwards from left to right, which means that in order to have more of banana, the consumer has to forego some mangoes. Secondly, as long as marginal utility of commodity is positive, an individual will always prefer more of that commodity, as more of the commodity will increase the level of satisfaction. It means higher indifference curve gives greater level of utility. Consider the different combination of bananas and mangoes A, B and C depicted in the graph. Combinations A, B and C consist of same quantity of mango but different quantities of bananas. Since combination B has more bananas than A, B will provide the individual a higher level of satisfaction than A. Therefore, B will lie on a higher indifference curve than A, depicting higher satisfaction. Likewise, C has more bananas than B. Quantity of mangoes is the same in both B and C. Therefore, C will provide higher level of satisfaction than B and also lie on a higher indifference curve than B. Thus, we can say that the higher indifference curve gives greater level of utility. Two indifference curves never intersect each other. In case two indifference curves intersecting each other, it will always lead to conflicting results. Let us allow two indifference curves to intersect each other as shown in this graph. As points A and B lie on the same indifference curve, IC1, utility is derived from combination A and combination B will give the same level of satisfaction. Similarly, as points A and C lie on the same indifference curve, IC2, utility derived from combination A and from combination C will give the same level of satisfaction. From this, it follows that utility from point B and from point C will also be the same. But this is clearly an absurd result, as on point B, the consumer gets a greater number of mangoes with the same quantity of bananas. So, the consumer is better off at point B than at point C. Thus, it is clear that intersecting indifference curves will lead to conflicting results. Thus, two indifference curves cannot intersect each other. So, this is all about utility. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Constructing Minds for more such academic videos.